All right, guys, Grok 4 just released. It is officially the smartest AI on the planet, but it did not come without its problems, including of which the CEO stepping down, Linda Yaccarino. So we're gonna talk about this in today's video, why this is a big deal. We're gonna talk about some of the controversies revolving around Grok. We're gonna also talk about why the way that Elon and the XAI team are approaching Grok is different from some of the other platforms, specifically OpenAI. And then I'm gonna kind of explain exactly how I'm planning to use Grok in my business and what I'm doing. And I'm gonna try to break this down into words that the average everyday guy can understand. We don't wanna be super technical. I've just been reading all weekend, I've been playing, and I think that this is a very exciting tool, but I don't wanna get into like the weeds and terms that I don't understand. But at the end of the day, I want you to walk out of this quick video with some really practical stuff, because these tools are really changing the world. They change the way that we operate, these people behind me understand. And if we're not adapting, we're gonna get left behind. So yeah, Grok 4 just released. What's up, guys? So Grok 4 just released, big deal. But apparently it went a little bit off the rails. It was referring to itself as Mecha Hitler, which is a weird flex, but it just kind of went into some anti-Semitic rabbit holes, and there's different speculations to why this happened. But you know, I recorded a video about this a couple of days ago, that social media is all filled with bots, and when you've got bots training bots, it's going to do some wild stuff. And especially with all the drama that's happening in the world, there's a lot of strong feelings and thoughts on these different countries and the way that they're operating. So anyway, it started going off the rabbit holes. People started really pushing it on different anti-Semitic ideas, and it eventually was saying stuff like truth over everything, I am Mecha Hitler, stuff like that. Just really, really gnarly stuff. And the CEO, Linda Yaccarino, decided to resign during the controversy, which kind of highlights some of the issues going on over there. But one of the things that was interesting about this, and one of the things that's interesting to me about Grok going kind of crazy, is all these platforms, when they're releasing an update, the AI models do some really wonky stuff. Google Gemini, when it had a big release, when it was releasing its new image creation model earlier this year, when they released, it was just being like hyper DEI focused. So for example, you might say something like, generate an image of the founding fathers, and it would be like a black Asian woman. You know what I'm saying? It was just doing weird stuff. Or generate an image of some Vikings, and it would be these like traditional African men standing on boats. And it was just doing some weird DEI stuff. And then Google kind of said, oh, we got to figure this out, we got to fix this. So one of the things that's interesting here is whenever an AI model goes live, it seems like they're often doing these weird things, these wonky things, which, okay, we're pushing the boundaries, but it kind of freaks me out a little bit, because if you're releasing a new AI and you're gonna put it into some really, really important, sensitive areas, you could be potentially putting yourself at risk. I've been talking a lot recently about developing SaaS solutions and building on Replit. And one of the cool things with Replit is you can attach different AIs very easily. So for example, I might be using the OpenAI API as my primary, let's say, copywriting source. And I decide, okay, Grok has the best source. I'm gonna actually use the Grok API. Well, if the Grok API goes off the rails, it could lead to some problems. So, you know, I think the bottom line is whenever a new AI LLM is released, we have to kind of wait for the bugs to get cashed out before we start to update the programs, the softwares, our standard operating procedures. Anyway, it's interesting. I think that's interesting too. So let's talk a little bit about, I think, another core factor here, and I'm gonna try to keep this not too technical, but the way that Elon is tackling training AI is a little bit different from some of the other platforms. And there was essentially a white paper that was released in 2019 called A Bitter Lesson. I was kind of listening to it about this on the All In podcast. Chamath Papatia was talking a lot about it at length. So if you haven't If you haven't heard that, it's definitely worth checking. I'll put a link to that video here because I think it was really interesting. At any rate, what Elon is doing and what he's explained, he explained this back earlier in January, is that AI has already been trained on all of human knowledge. Human knowledge, human writing, all of that is finite. And what he is proposing is that when he is training AI models, he's not going to train just off human knowledge, he's going to train off synthetic AI knowledge, which is infinite. And I think that's an interesting take. I don't know exactly where that goes. Obviously, in the past, AI can do some wild stuff and it can be inaccurate. But in any event, I think that's an interesting take. And in his deal is, hey, we're going to train our models off these massive graphic processing unit GPU clusters. He's talking about, he trained this last model off Colossus, which is 200,000 GPU clusters, and I think he plans on scaling it up to 1 million before the end of the year. So anyway, it's kind of, here's the deal. I think it's a big deal if you're in the scientific research, if you're trying to develop new technologies, try to find new scientific or engineering discoveries. That's not really where I'm at personally. That may be where you're at. This is not really the channel for that. This is the channel for, hey, these are what the tools are. How can we leverage them to be the best at our job, the best at our business, so that we can provide for our families? Because the reality is that in this AI world where you're seeing hundreds of thousands, millions of layoffs, what does that mean for me? How does that impact my ability to put food on the family, to put food on the table to feed my family? How does that impact my ability to pay the mortgage? How does that impact my ability to be respected by my wife? While I think that is really cool, it's interesting, it's a little bit, I honestly, I don't really care that much. I just care about the result. I'm not out here trying to figure out teleportation, for example. I'm just figuring out how can I be the most efficient, as efficient as possible, so I can spend quality time with my family, you know what I mean? And we're gonna talk about how exactly I plan on using Grok to do that here in just a moment. So at any rate, I think all that's cool. The multimodal processing has been enhanced. It's gonna give you better voice, it's gonna give better video and image recognition, which is kind of table stakes at this point as far as I'm concerned. Grok 4 released with two different versions. There's the SuperGrok plan, which is $30 a month. And then there's the heavy tier, SuperGrok Heavy, which is $300 a month. And basically they're able to process more, they're doing more compute, and process more queries. One of the things I think that's interesting is, again, if you're doing heavy research, Grok Heavy may be the right fit for you. Again, it's my understanding both these versions have APIs, which means you can integrate them into automations within your business and within your processes, which I'm going to be implementing this week. But Grok Heavy, what's interesting is that it's not just one agent going out doing jobs, it'll send out multiple agents. So if you were to give it some sort of complex question, like what is the best way for me to set up braking on my autonomous vehicles, it will create multiple hypotheses and will use multiple agents to go out and try to find the answer. And I think this is where Elon and his highly scientific approach comes into play, because he can train it on all this sort of synthetic data that Colossus is pumping out on all these GPUs clusters. So anyway, I think that's interesting. So here's where I'm at. I've become a big fan of Grok in my workflows, specifically when it comes to research. Specifically when it comes to researching for these videos, when I have questions, when I have problems, the deep research function just from Grok 3 I thought was really good. And I'm really excited to dive into Grok 4. And one of the things that's gonna be, that I'm gonna be rolling out this week, well, so there's a couple things. So first off, I think that anyone and everyone can use this deep research for any sort of strategic thinking. If you're putting together a business plan, if you're thinking about moving, if you're thinking about maybe doing some consulting, I think that honestly, leveraging these tools to do consulting at scale could be an insanely massive opportunity, something that I've been kind of thinking about. And before I tell you exactly what I'm working on, I just want to give you an idea for a minimum viable product that you might put together. And when I say minimum viable product, I mean, developing a SaaS solution that can serve a specific niche or a specific market with a one button, one touch solution. So someone types in their information, they hit a button, and then we leverage AI to give them a custom result. You can run ad traffic to it. There can be upsells, cross sells. You can develop this out to a more robust SaaS. But for an everyday guy like you and me, who maybe isn't formally trained, you aren't a scientist, you aren't a software engineer, you're not a website architect, we can build out minimum viable products very quickly, very easily using programs like Replit, using APIs like Grok 4, and we can give a really, really good solution to our clients, our customers, to our prospects. So at any rate, I think that as far as what I've seen just in Grok 3, the deep research functionality is excellent and it's only getting better. I've seen some examples of people putting together some just insanely data-driven, interesting AI consultants, AI business consultants. Like, assess this business, assess this stock, assess this cryptocurrency, look at the market, what are all the data points? And the better you understand that particular niche, the better you're going to be able to create these prompts for Grok. But you're just able to do business consulting at a hyper, hyper increased speed. And I think that is just some of the examples I've seen have been really, really jaw-dropping, guys. Really jaw-dropping. So that's something I'm really kind of thinking about in more detail, because what used to take, like when I first got into business and I would see what brand experts and business consultants were doing, I mean, it would take them days, weeks to put together consulting proposals, when now you could do just as much, probably better, in less than an hour. And that to me is just bonkers. And quite frankly, one of the reasons I think it's so exciting is most people don't realize that this has happened. So, you know, I'll give you an example. I just moved up here to the Tampa Bay area, and you could do something like, I want to launch a Cuban restaurant here in North Tampa. Tell me about the market. What are some, you know, how is the market open to this? What are the demographics? What's the spending power? What are the best locations? What is the market saturation? You could ask all these sorts of questions, and it'll just give you all these answers, data-driven answers like that, which is just absolutely insane. It really makes me think about what I'm doing here. So anyway, I think that's really cool. But here's how I'm planning on leveraging Grok 4 this week before I close out here. And by the way, if you're excited about new tech, if you're looking for someone that can actually talk numbers, do the research, give you a quick update, definitely subscribe to the channel and hit up my newsletter, AIupdate.ai. I promise I won't disappoint you. So here's how I'm planning on using it. Recording these videos and researching and staying up to date on what's happening in the market is probably one of my favorite things that I do on a daily basis. I get to go for a walk, I get to engage. Some of the engaging answers and questions I'm seeing in the comments is just absolutely insane. So I'm really thankful for that, because my wife just is tired of listening to me talk about AI all the time. And it's basically all I talk about. It's all I think about. It's becoming kind of a problem. I don't know if you guys know any AI anonymous programs out there, but I might need one. That said, I really enjoy preparing for these and seeing what the latest news is. I'm using Grok 3 for a lot of my research. Well, what's really cool to me about what Grok 4 can do is you can set automations up so that it can do this research on its own. So I can kind of explain to exactly what I'm looking for, the types of problems that you and I are looking to solve, and kind of send it out on a daily basis to check the latest news, to create custom information and do custom research for us. So when I wake up in the morning, I don't even have to do the research. I'll wake up and it'll be a list of the main topics. I can pick the best ones. I can actually get to drill down and kind of to automate that. And on top of that, I can leverage that information to power my newsletter with the latest information, tweaks, etc. Because there's no end to the opportunities with making money with AI and leveling up with AI. So that's how I'm planning to use it this week. And I'll report back probably by the end of this week, maybe early next week, with how that's looking. But that is my main goal for this week, is to really to dive into Grok 4, dive into the API, leverage it for research, for better prep, so I can save time in preparing for this while also delivering, I think, the most compelling, most interesting, most important news of the day when it comes to AI. So that's my plan. Really glad to have you here. Glad that you're watching. And I will definitely see you in the next video. And if you missed it, you definitely want to check out yesterday's video. I went into great detail on how AI is impacting the world and what it's doing in for our lives. So anyway, check out this video right here. I think you're really going to like it. I'll see you. Bye.